Pog champ. What's going on?
These nuts! Snug, snug, snug. Did you have a good slip? I sure as hell did. Work was pretty poggers too, if I do say so myself. Don't sleep, only work? Sure you don't. You sleep on the clock easy, clap. Sodafish knows what's up. Long time no see, Sodafish. How you been? I started doing this thing where sometimes if I'm still asleep, I'll crawl into bed for like 15 minutes and then wake up and get back to work. If you do it in certain increments, my boss doesn't realize. But you have to be careful because sometimes, well, you can't always control your sleeping habits, right? Sometimes shit goes wrong. Doing good? I'm glad to hear it. Welcome back to the stream. We're currently setting up. We are ready to continue our playthrough of Deus Ex in just a bit. Hey, reverse cards. Currently suffering third degree heat stroke because I made the foolish mistake of using your oven for 45 minutes. I'm sorry to hear that. I hope you recover soon. I didn't know there's different degrees to heat stroke. Supervisor, your mouse hasn't moved in 47 minutes. It's not quite that strict. It's more like, so, Mr. Host, or Mrs. Host, or whatever the fuck gender you are, host, how is it that it took you 25 minutes to do a single account, which normally takes you two? And I'd be like, and he'd be like, look, I don't usually give a shit, but the middle management that actually controls everything I do is asking me why you're doing this, and I'm running out of excuses. So it's like, never, it won't happen again, sir. And they'll be like, yeah, I'm sure it won't. Please, please make my job easier, little, or easier, host, so I don't need to keep bullshitting for you. No, real talk, my supervisor is a class act. I do not deserve his level of patience, but you know what? I mean, well, actually, I have no snappy repartee or no snappy response to that. Sometimes people got your back, and you just have to acknowledge that they're pretty much burning their ass to keep you in one piece. There are practical reasons for this. They can't really afford to lose another employee because we're understaffed as it is, and at the same time, my bosses do not enjoy micromanagement. However, the people above them sure as hell do. So, you know, the buck has got to stop somewhere. So basically, if I fuck around, my supervisor takes the heat for it, and he takes the heat for it too many times. It's not just my ass that gets burned, it's his too. And that's not good for anyone, is it? The least I can do is to lower the frequency with which they have to bust their ass. Sounds like weakness. Exploit it. Which part is the weak part, incidentally? All of it? Are you calling me weak? I see I'll need to show you who is the true bot, who is the bottom in this relationship. Also, my hair is fucking wet as shit. I need to dry this off. This is not gonna. Otherwise, wearing. Have you tried wearing headphones fresh out of shower without drying your hair properly? Yeah, it's not a good feeling. No, you're Uwu Visor, doing things for others. Uwu Visor. Are you saying my Uwu Visor should exploit me? Is that what you're trying to imply? Joke's on you. I'm already capitalism's bitch. I am sweating like an anime girl on a black couch. Ayo? What do you expect us to do with this information? Supervisor? Hey, Steel. Welcome, welcome. Fuck! I forgot to update the subscriber icons tonight, or again. Y'all remind me to do that tonight after we turn off for the evening. It's been long enough. It's time to update those so that y'all have some cute subscriber icons to show off. And I do have quite a few of them. I don't know how many Twitch allows me to upload, but I will try to upload all of them. I haven't even found all of them. I only found most of them. Some of them are missing. And what's weird is they should all be in the same place because they're all commissioned at roughly they're all made for me at roughly the same time. So, you know, I shouldn't have to like wait, and I shouldn't, they should all be in the same location. I shouldn't have to dig for them, but it has been a few years since I got these. So they're probably just hidden in the absolute junkyard that is my old hard drives. Nothing, I say shit and just let you deal with the consequences. Oh, you're in good company, because that's pretty much the entirety of my relationship with my mods and also, or with my mods. Do my hands even work right now? Okay, my hands work. Cool, cool. What am I doing? Yesterday, my troubles seem so far away. Yesterday. Oh, thank you for the sub, Steel. Sub? Well, you remembered, and that's all that's important. Oh, shit. Fuck. I'm being attacked. I'm being attacked. I forgot that's a thing that is occurring. Alright, we're all ready to rumble. And everyone's here tonight. Pog Champ. Poggers. If I may do say. Bruh, Lol's getting fucked by a squeaky toy off screen? Wait, what the fuck? How did you extrapolate that? Where do you get? I am legitimately confused now. How the fuck did you extrapolate me into being fucked by a squeaky toy off screen? That's what the sub sound effect sounds like. I mean, okay. I'm lost for words. I've never thought of it that way. Do you mean to tell me that every time someone submits to my channel that I am fucking them off screen and it sounds like screwing a chew toy? Just frenzied slapping and squeaking noises. Submission. Yes, I do believe that is what I said. Oh, I read it. It seems like I got a bit backwards. Apparently I'm the one being fucked by squeaky toys off screen. Every time a sub sound effect occurs. Well, whatever floats your boat, you know. Are there five chapters in this DLC? Fuck me. It took forever to finish the first one. Alright, so where we last left off, this piece of ass basically gave us a mission to do shit, I suppose. Last time we were playing, I was told to kill everything and to not use stealth anymore. Which is probably why, during her dialogue, she kept chastising me for killing all of her men. Not just some of them, but mostly all of them. Well, unfortunately, while it was fun to do that for a little while, it turns out that playing a genocide run in this game is not any easier than doing stealth runs, so we're gonna go stealthy for a little bit. We also have two praxis kits, chat. So we could totally use this to fill some of these out. But I'm going to keep them for now and until we run into a situation which would be a pain in the ass to navigate otherwise. Let's go visit Keithner really quick. get ourselves some ammunition of sorts. My boat doesn't float. Your boat doesn't float. Ayo. I'll float your boat. Whatever floats your scroat? You would know about floating scroats, wouldn't you? Alright, so how do I get up here again? It's a good thing there's so many of these manlet-sized tunnels all over the place, right? Can you imagine how difficult this game would be otherwise? Sure, it's taking a while, buddy. Old pal. Ayo, Bitwar Sweet followed me. So that's why. I'm actually really close to getting 500 followers, chat. This is kind of amazing. It's been a while since I had a milestone. Very pog, champ, if I do say myself. Oh. Oh, this is the army I tried to access before, but I couldn't.
Are you Quinn?
Well, if it ain't the bloody Grim Reaper himself.
What are you talking about?
Christ almighty, lad. You got half the garrison shitting themselves and afraid to go out on patrol. Look.
I love his accent.
The commander said to help you. That's what I'll do. Just don't kill me, all right? I got children. Eat them. Well, look, I don't really have yet, but... All right, I don't really have any. Just don't fucking shoot me.
Relax. I'm not here to hurt you.
Well, whether that's true or not, I'll take some comfort knowing there's 3 inches of bulletproof glass between us.
Look, Keitner's...
Oh, honey, 3 inches of bulletproof glass is not going to help you help Jack all.
I'm just glad you came as soon as you did instead of going off on your own. There's enough kegs of powder lying around here already without throwing another loose cannon in the mix. You know how much we're risking to keep you off the radar? We've only got so much pull around here. It's Burke's show. And he'll do as he bloody well pleases, which means stamping out any rats the moment he gets wind of them.
I'm grateful, but can we get on with it? I understand you run a nice little sideline in procurement.
Aye. From time to time, you might say being inclined to do a little, how should we call it?
Bartern.
On the side. Since the commander signed off on it, I suppose I could open my stock to you. For a price, that is.
You mean I have to pay?
Of course you have to bloody well pay.
Ain't exactly a fucking army quartermaster down here. I'm just a civvy contractor trying to make ends meet. This ain't a bleeding charity.
Considering the circumstances.
Circumstances? What, that you're a fugitive, and I'm risking my neck just talking to you? What are you trying to pull here? Although, I don't suppose you had anything to do with the stasis pod that was saved back in the ship.
How do you know about that?
Ah, so it was you, eh? Well, let's just say I have me sources and your little random act of kindness didn't go unnoticed. Tell you what, I'll give you a discount on me wares. Just... no freebies or handouts. But now that I think of it, if you're looking for a little something for nothing and don't mind a little light work, I've got an errand that could use running. Consider it a special offer of sorts. Interested?
I'll give you 3... that's a self-own. Oh my god. Still, that is a few more inches than a few people I know. Anyway. I'm kind of surprised. Well, maybe I shouldn't be surprised that eventually saving that stasis pod from earlier in the game was going to come back to make my life easier. But it's still nice that it occurred. So I don't know if killing everyone on this ship actually affected the dialogue or not. It makes me wonder if there's any point in replaying this to figure it out. Because at the very beginning of the game, they were going on and on about how you were this super fucked up or super suited up psycho cyborg that murdered the shit out of all their men. And that was before you actually got to do anything. So it implies that it doesn't matter if you kill anyone on the ship or not, because the dialogues can be the same, right? But I would like confirmation if that's the case. I have no intention of replaying this game with a completely pacifist run anyway, but, you know. It'd be nice to know.
What exactly do you do here, Quinn?
In a more civilized world, you might say I pass for the base's lead maintenance engineer. But if you look at it from Beltar's point of view, I might as well just be a glorified janitor. Pay's good, though, so, you know, not complaining.
If the pay is good, why the underground market?
Well, why not? You see, civilian contractors operate under different jurisdiction when it comes to bringing outside goods into the base. So while the rank and file grunts can only order and receive essentials, toothpaste and the like, I, being the entrepreneurial chap that I am, offer them a more robust catalog of goods and services. You know the sort.
Smoke, beverages, gentlemen's literature.
How does this involve weapons?
Now, let me finish. As an enterprising fellow, I require an exchange of valuables for these slightly less than essential supplies, and often receive some very non-civilian contractor regulated equipment in exchange, if you catch me drift. Now, normally, I launder my stock through a contact on the mainland, but a deal in Shanghai recently fell through, so lucky for you, I've got some excess inventory to move. Consider this whole arrangement a matter of fortunate timing.
And Keitner is okay with all of this?
Not exactly. You see, some time ago, the commander got wind of my little operation down here. But before she could throw me in the brig, I offered her something I knew she couldn't refuse. Information. I ain't bragging, but I've managed to build myself quite a little network of sparrows and gophers. I'd known for a while that she'd been at odds with that prick, Burke. In the end, I reached a rather simple mutual agreement. I keep her in the loop, and she keeps my neck out of the noose, so to speak.
Pog champ.
What can you tell me about this base?
Nothing you don't know, probably. To the outside world, it's a Beltar Naval Logistics headquarters and supply point for their Pacific operations. Beneath the surface, though, it's much,
much more.
How so?
Look, nothing personal, mate, but I prefer the commander to most of the informing. As far as I'm concerned, the less I know, and more importantly, the less I say in this matter, the better off we all are.
I gotta say, I love the acting, though.
Tell me about the commander, Keitner.
Lieutenant Commander, officially. But the grunts don't pay no mind to that. She's the commander as far as they're concerned. It's the Reds who stick to the formalities, you see. Because they're Burke's boys. The Spooks. Special Operations. You might say there's a bit of a division of loyalty among the troops.
Between Keitner's men and Burke's?
Aye. Since time immortal, there's always been a rivalry of sorts between grunts and spooks. I always assumed it came down to ego. But it's different here. Probably because Burke's different.
What do you mean?
Well, for a start, the man might be a righteous prick, but he's got the respect of his men. And the higher-ups think he's a visionary based on some fancy tech he drummed up a few years back. In other words, the man's got a lot of influence and a lot of power, and, well, I don't think that old proverb needs repeating here.
This is starting to feel like this whole DLC could have just been its own game. Because I was thinking, like, I was expecting this DLC to be a lot smaller, a lot more simple, because that's usually how DLC expansion shit is in games these days, but this is like, it has all its own characters and its own intrigue, and the voice acting is decent, and the dialogue is fucking long as shit. I was not prepared. And that's also why I was surprised why it was taking so long to beat it. Alright, so let's see the special offer.
Tell me about this special offer.
Look, I don't know if you've noticed yet, but this base is packing some serious heat. Especially in the form of those walking brick shit has.
It is like a Borderlands DLC, it's just a full game on itself.
A little something to make getting around easier, if you catch my meaning.
What kind of something are we talking about here?
Nothing fancy. Just a 329 series MPRS.
A rocket launcher?
Yes.
Custom built.
By yours truly, of course.
You see? I might be able to get my fingers on some low-level arms. I'm a little restricted when it comes to military-grade bells and whistles, and I'm itching to try out a new trigger propulsion mix. Maybe even recalibrate the guidance system for some extra punch.
Well, I find your something this could come in handy. I'm not convinced jury rig explosives are exactly my style. I disagree. This is perfect for me. I like the sound of this. So, I don't know which one I would choose. Sounds messy or sounds perfect? Actually, you know, I like the sound of this.
Fucking right, you like the sound of this. It's the bollocks. Look, all you gotta do is find me some components. I'll do the rest. An earlier boat had a shipment of 329s, but I wasn't able to poach any of them before they made it to the armory. Luckily, little Sparrow in my employ managed to lose one through maintenance circulation, but he got himself shit canned before I could collect. Now my little butte's lying around the base somewhere in bloody pieces. The launcher, I mean, not the wee man. No idea really happened to him.
Right, so long story short, you need me to find the parts and bring them back to you.
Yeah, that about sums it up, I'd say. Just find me the trigger module, scope assembly, and launcher barrel, and we're in business. I could scrape up the rest from leftovers here in the shop.
I'll see what I can find. Any idea where they are?
If I knew that, I would have picked them up myself. You're just gonna have to make do and keep your nose to the ground. Check the obvious places first, like the cargo and receiving areas. Worst case, someone found one of the parts and brought it to administration. I looked there last.
Got it.
Oh, for fuck's sake, this is going to... I hope they did not hide them that well. Otherwise, this is going to just drill into my fucking cyber brain for the next several weeks that we play this game, because I am that OCD about finding shit.
What are you buying?
Let's see what they got for sale. And we also should sell some of our shit here that we don't need. Like, the heavy rifle is great and all, but I'm not very good at using heavy weapons. At least not the heavy rifle, because it has such a low... It has such a large wind-up time. Usually if I'm going to kill people, I'm going to be doing it from afar with a shotgun. But what do you have on offer? Oh, shit. Hey, they got beer. Beer. Hypto-stim. Cyber boost energy packs. Laser targeting system. And a Praxis kit. Don't mind if I do. He sells all this ammunition, but no guns. I guess we don't really need those guns right now anyway. But yeah, we're selling the heavy machine gun, which is more like a minigun, because it's such a pain in the ass to use. I don't need that. I don't really use any of the mine templates either. So we're going to sell those. We're going to keep the grenades though.
Satisfaction guaranteed. Unless of course you fuck it up yourself.
I want to get inside his room so I can loot those cases there. There's got to be like a freaking vent or something. I'm sure if I looked hard enough, I could probably find one. I wonder if he's going to be upset of me breaking in though. I guess I could always just punch him out, right? Alright, so I have 4 Praxis kits now, and I did say get inside him. Ah, your wish is my command, Steel. But first, I need to decide. I have 4 Praxis kits available, and I should probably be using these. Should I? We're not going to use any of it just yet. Alright, so I need to remember where he is so I can come back, so I could find a way inside there. No, in my luck, it's probably nearby and I probably just missed it. Jump and heavy lift augment objects are my favorite augments. They're fairly useful. So I'll keep that in mind in case I ever run into another situation where I need to get somewhere and it's being obscured by something dumb like a heavy object. And I say heavy object in air quotes. Thank you for the head pat, Neko Rin. How are you doing tonight? Welcome to the Lost Time Show. Welcome. Why does this place look familiar? Oh, because I've been here before. Okay. I don't remember why I've been here before, though. Okay, so there, and then there's a thing down there, and I know I've been here before. I hope there wasn't a rocket launcher part just sitting there that I missed. Or I'm gonna be upset. Did I read this part? Okay, so we got another code somewhere. Thank you for the head pats. I'm wondering if this air duct over here leads to that thing that was just being discussed. Because I don't remember picking up that pocket secretary earlier. You got me wondering, can I get XP shutdown tune as Linux shutdown tune? You probably could. I mean, I was exploring Linux for a bit, but then I kind of fucked up Manjaro, so I put that on hold for now. But Linux being Linux, you should be able to edit something like, modify something like that, right? Was this here before? I don't remember there being a data storage device here before. Is this what they thought that hard drives would look like back in 20... When was this game produced? When was this game released? Yeah, 2013. I could have sworn it was earlier than that. I wonder if this game, if this is what the people who developed this game back in the early 2010s thought that hard drives would evolve to in the 2020s, because this game takes place in 2027 and it's currently 2023. You use Linux Mint? I didn't touch Manjaro yet. Well, according to Vimboy, you can, so there you have it. Your relationship with this game is love-hate? Kind of the same. I definitely think the original Deus Ex is still better, but I like Deus Ex Human Revolution for what it was at the time. The only thing that I've generally found unforgivable are the forced boss fights. Add one data storage. I don't remember why I had to pick this up. It looks like I already read this stuff then. Did I just miss this thing the first time I walked through here? Yeah, I must have, because I clearly fucked around with these at one point. I don't remember there being a weapons cabinet here before either. I'm gonna sell these machine pistols back to the armory guy. I have 200 health again. Hold up. You see it? Beer! Hell yeah! Alcohol! On a Deus Ex game, it's possible to miss a lot of stuff. Yeah, it's very true. I've never even finished Deus Ex Human Revolution. This will probably be the first time in God knows how many years that I've actually managed to play this game to completion. I usually stop around this DLC. I lose interest and such. What the fuck is... Okay. I think what we're going to do... We're going to head to the cargo bay area.
Access granted.
And we're going to... search in those places for these rocket launcher parts. And I'll spend some time looking for the... I'll go to administration and look for the other one, because hopefully the reason why the game told me to go look in the administration is because it's actually there and not because it's a red herring. Because, you know, that'd be cruel, right? This fucking map is so big as it is. I hope to God that was an actual hint and it's not like, oh, her there, it might be administration, it might not be. Because that would be definitely a... exercise in frustration. I finished this back on the 360 and I hated the game back then. Why did you hate the game back then? Didn't play this game sequel. Lack of time. Mine do now. That's on GOG now, I think. Oh, I see. Actually, I have Mankind Divided also, but I never did get to play it since I never finished this game. And I'm kind of a stickler for playing games in their orders when I can. And then after I play Mankind Divided, we're going to play the original Deus Ex, hopefully with some graphics mods installed to make it look extra pretty. Because I played Deus Ex back on new Windows 98 and that game was awesome. Yeah, it was. Did you play Invisible War also? And Deus Ex in one of these games that don't need graphic mods because of how awesome it was, indeed. Please comply. It indeed does not need graphics mods. If I just suggested that I put those on there anyway because at the time that I played and beat the original Deus Ex, they were still working on it. And it's been years since that happened, so I can only assume that they must be completed by now. How can you possibly make J.C. Denton any more attractive? It doesn't make him attractive, it just makes the environments more attractive. Ooh, credit chips. I got some experience and some money, but I don't think that gave me the parts I'm looking for, chat. Too heavy, too heavy, too heavy. Shut the fuck up, game. I feel like if I go back here, I won't be able to get out. I also wish I had a flashlight right now. The game looks nice and bright on the stream, but does not look nice and bright in front of me because I insist on playing with realistic lighting, or semi-realistic lighting, I should say. Even though the game is currently taking place in a very dark and hard-to-see area, the issue with Deus Ex is also one of these games you will never finish because of all the side quests. That's very true. That's why it's taking God knows how long. Also, I can't see shit, Captain. God damn. Realistic yellow lighting. Yes, indeed. We're also not playing the director's cut. The director's cut apparently had a lot of issues, so I figured, fuck it. We're playing the original with all the yellow filter gloriness. I just realized something. I wonder if after beating this DLC, if it's going to return my original stats and shit from the previous game. Or if it's going to... Actually, I guess it wouldn't because this is not the director's cut. Meaning the DLC is not attached to the main game right now. This is a standalone game. Director's cut fixed stuff and broke stuff at the same time, exactly. That's why I decided I wasn't going to play the director's cut, I'll just play the original. Okay. This is already kind of becoming a nightmare, chat. I'm looking for... Oh, thank God. They still flash. The parts still flash, chat. There we go. We got the trigger module thing. And thankfully they count as quest items, meaning they're not going to take up any space. Alright, so we got the trigger module. So the other parts should be somewhere out. The other parts should be somewhere here in the cargo bay. In one of these boxes. Civilian contractors must stay within designated areas. Entering restricted areas will result in termination and prosecution. Terminate and prosecute this dick and balls. Oh, that's a killjoy. Oh, this is the same container. that kind of pisses me off. Get the fuck out of my way. There's no way to get around there. The only acceptable HD remaster is the RE4 HD project, where they track down the location of the reference images for every texture in RE4 and rebuild each one by hand. Io? Capcom actually went the distance with that? That's kind of cool. Sniper rifle ammo? Is there a sniper rifle in this level somewhere? Mine template. I really need lights. I actually can't see shit. Oh my god. I'm using the stream version of the game to actually be able to see, because I'm too stubborn to just turn on the brightness settings in-game. If it gets too bad, I will be forced to. Not Capcom, a bunch of random guys who love the game. Maguri Project is also a decent HD remake. I have a lot of modern games to play, like Elite Dangerous, I just chose old games to play. There's a lot of more old games I would like to play in stream. I'm thinking about booting up the original StarCraft and Brood War. All grounding orders have been rescinded. New flight schedules will be distributed as soon as possible. Shout out to Kingdom Hearts though, where they didn't have the code and had to reverse engineer from a PS2 copy, bruh. I think I'm gonna go mad searching through all these goddamn boxes. Are there more boxes upstairs? No? Alright, so we went through that one. Yeah, they did an oopsie and deleted the source code. Bruh.
Civilian contractors must stay within designated areas. Entering restricted areas will result in termination and prosecution.
Access granted.
I'm pretty sure I've been up here already. Yeah, I've been up here already.
Cargo crew to Sector Alpha. Cargo crew.
It's in one of these topmost containers, isn't it? Do I wonder if I have to do a if I have to do some platforming to get to it, or if it's just like sitting up? Is that it over there? There's a machine pistol on the ground. Where am I gonna look next? We can't enter here. It's closed up. But what if I went over? There's nothing back here either, is there? Oh? But what about up here? I wonder if the jump, if I need the... Can I get up there? Actually? You have no idea how common that happens in software engineering on big companies? I mean, it happened to Homeworld. They had to redo Homeworld 1 from scratch when Gearbox released it on PC again, or re-released it. And it was inferior for a lot of reasons. One of the reasons was that in the original Homeworld, when ships fire projectiles, the projectiles were actual, like, objects floating in space that could actually hit anything they passed by. So you would have little fighter craft flying by, and if they, and they could actually get hit by the flying, by these giant mass drivers, which were meant to be used against capital ships. In Homeworld 2, they didn't have anything like that, and it was just calculated. It was an RNG chance to determine damage values for enemy ships that were struck by them. So in the remake of Homeworld 1, they had to just make it based off the Homeworld 2 engine. So as you can imagine, that's sad, because the devs did not know how to redo that how to redo those projectiles for the remake of Homeworld 1.
Security credentials must be carried at all times. You may be asked to produce said credentials by security personnel. Please comply.
Do I want to spend skill points on the jumping add-on? I feel like there are secrets up there, and I don't know if I can get up there via vents and shit. I could just save a fucking... Oh, come on. I guess I could just create a save. Save is number 18. And I did say that I was going to choose my augmentations based off of, like... It is consistently odd. You can just bypass whole shits. So... Okay. Because I feel like that's where they would hide it, right? They would hide it in a place that requires platforming. I killed myself. Yep, I knew it was going to happen. Hello, ladies, have you? Thanks for coming to tonight's stream, everyone, by the way. Always appreciated. Now then, jumping. Whoop-hoo! If the Chosen Undead could jump, you could skip 75% of Dark Souls 2. Woo! Hey, I made it this time. Okay. Okay. Shit. Come on, come on. Oh, yeah. Now we're cooking. Oh yeah, I can't see shit, Captain. I literally feel like I'm gonna fall off any second now, because I literally cannot see worth a damn. Ayo? Praxis kit? Haha! Oh. This was totally worth it. Oh, base devs, of course they knew someone would try to explore up here. We're saving this. I have three Praxis kits again. Pog. Paid for itself, yes it did. You see that mountain? You can go there. See those little girders at the very top of the warehouse? You can climb up there with the correct jumping add-on. See this vent cover? Pathfinder 300 experience. It's been a while since I've seen that experience point boost for exploration. Ayo, Gazayamus. I can feel it in my bones, chat. It must be here. It must be here somewhere. Is there anything here that I'm missing? I need to go back the way I came anyway to explore all the other areas that I missed that were on top. Is there anything over here? It's not letting me jump over this tiny fucking... God damn it, game. I feel like I'm gonna kill myself any minute now. Okay. Just climb over here. Come on. I feel like I'm in the Super Mario Brothers movie again. Just climbing and all... casually climbing around all these very, very thin things. By the way, the Super Mario Brothers movie is fairly good. It wasn't, like, outstanding or anything, but it kind of felt like the Lego movie in the same way, in the same way where you didn't expect that much. You didn't expect it to be charmingly funny for adult viewers, but it ended up being charmingly funny for adult viewers anyway. Especially that Star Kid thing, or whatever the fuck that little sprite, blue sprite thing was. You'll know what I mean when you see it. Let's not fall to our deaths, please. Let's not fall to our deaths, please. At least not right now. Did I fucking save? There we go. I wonder if I can jump over there. Yep, up. Yep, here we go. There's literally a light here, chat. So, maybe there's something here too? No? Well, that's decidedly unpog. Yeah. Oh, shit! I did not die. How am I floating? How am I even suspended in the air right now? Oh. Okay. Oh, I understand where we are now. Okay. Houston, we are fucking lost again. All right, let's get back upstairs. I mean, if I can. Okay, this is the entrance, okay? Oh my fucking god. Yeah, no, I was not about to lose that because of something that dumb. Where, oh where, is the little rocket launcher part? Where, oh where, could it be? Be very, very quiet. I am hunting parts for a rocket launcher. Huh? Looks like it stopped storming outside too. I suppose it would have been too easy if it was just out here, huh? A rocket launch here? Yeah, a rocket launch here. What did I say? You see, it's a launch here that has rockets in it. More shit to sell to the armory person. A rocket launch here, yeah. A launch here with rockets. I mean, that's a fairly easy concept to understand, right? Io? Stun gun? Stun gun darts? The game is giving me a clear and present answer. It wants me to play stealthy again. Is that the Metal Slug rocket launcher? No, you see, that's a rocket launcher, not a rocket launcher. Heavy machine gun is certainly a weapon that you could use in this game. Alright, let's go back upstairs, chat. It's obvious now that I'm not going to find it down here. Ah. Wait, whoa. He said it would be an administration. We're an administration. This is the admin center, isn't it? I already opened all this shit. So it's not there. Unless he meant like this kind of administration and not. Whee! Is there anything behind here? Oh, well, that's just pog. There's nothing back. Fucking hell. There's nothing back there. I'm sure we'll need that skill later anyway. Io? Could it be in one of these things and then one of the boxes over here? Maybe it's in that floating box over there, up there. We do a little platforming after all. Or maybe it's in that box over there. Aha! That's combat rifle ammunition. That's not what I was looking for. Game. God damn it. Game? I want my beer. Give me the beer! I mean, I'm carrying all this stuff already. I guess I just, Alright, fine. We'll leave that there for now. Those of you who are here who did not watch me play outward are probably unaware that I'm kind of addicted to just picking out, looting the shit out of everything and then stomping all the way back to a store just so I could sell all of it, even if it's garbage. It is certainly a habit. I do not apologize for that. I just lost all of my extra health from this weird jump. I'm kind of... I refused. Okay. Where was I? Oh, right. Yeah, I refused to accept that loss of health. That was really dumb. Why do I only have 132 health right now anyway? Do not mix alcohol and medications, chat. That's so bad for you. I mean, that's the reason I can't see now. Are you fucking kidding me? Shit! This game is so weird like that with fall damage, man. Look, the animation for falling with style is great, but it's still annoying that you even need to use that. My god. Time to get blackout drunk. Woo! I can't see shit, Captain! Fuck me, I can't see shit, Captain. Oh my god. This is actually making me feel nauseous in the meat space. Or rather, it's making the host feel nauseous. As if they don't drink enough as it is, or drink enough to begin with. I'm willing to bet you it's on top of this, of that stupid fucking thing up there. So we'll have to get over there somehow. Using platforming. Or maybe it's up here? Oh, for fuck's sake, game! Let me into the... Okay. Well, let me... Aha! Pathfinder 300. There it is! Launcher barrel for rocket launcher. And a reload speed upgrade. Cool. Completionist, 0 experience points. And a reload speed upgrade. Don't mind if I do. What am I gonna use that on anyway? The shotgun? Cool. I can only presume that there's not going to be any more parts here, given the circumstances. That would be silly. You know what, Steel? It's a good thing we took the leg upgrades after all. I don't think I would have been able to actually find these damn things otherwise. Let's do a little funny. We're gonna do some platforming and get ourselves killed. How'd I get up there before? Okay. What the f- Oh-ho! Aha! God damn it. Oh, shh. That's not what I wanted to do at all, chat. A memester's work is never done. We must get up there. Good thing these boxes don't shatter. At least I don't think they do. There we go. Okay. Alright, we just need one more box. Where did I throw the other box? Throw the box on. Are you shitting me right now? It needs energy? I didn't ask for this. Oh my god. I've never seen this before. I didn't know that carrying a fucking box requires energy. What do they have in here? It's not even recharging. Cringe. Such cringe. This is certainly the box gameplay of all time. There we go. Nope. The fucking... Curse you, video game physics. The orange box is nothing on this. Awesome. Okay, okay. Alright, we finally made it back up here, chat. It took us a while, but it was certainly worth the effort, I'm sure. Back to where we came. We will now proceed to see if I missed anything over here. I probably didn't, because we just got all the parts. Someone may ask, why did you bother going through getting the rocket launcher parts anyway if you're just going to try and stealth run the rest of this outside of the boss fights? And there's the operative word, boss fights. I want to see if you could beat the boss fights in this game by just shooting a rocket into it. Could've sworn I saw something flashing over here. There was a ladder here this whole time? Oh my fucking god. This game, sometimes. What's over here? Some popping, apparently. I wonder if that is a collectible item or if that's just a support pillar for the elevator. It's probably just a support pillar, isn't it? Oh! Fuck. Damn it. So anyway, I wonder where the final rocket launcher part is. Hopefully it won't be too difficult to get to. But I have a feeling there's a good chance that my hopes will be dashed. It wouldn't be a challenge otherwise. That took some damage there, but it looks like it was worth it. Sniper rifle ammo, baby. Or sniper, baby. I have too much junk, though. But I do need to use up some of these things anyway, such as my painkillers. My cyber boost bar over here. Still no room. I guess if I could just remember where this is, I could probably get it later. Can I drop the hypno darts though, because I don't have any hypnotizing stuff. I just have stun gun stuff. I haven't even found a combat rifle all game. As it were. Not yet, anyway. I guess if I really wanted to hoard stuff, I could just spend those points on increasing my inventory space, right? But I'm kind of worried, what if I need them to place into dermal armor so I don't die so quickly against, like, the boss or some shit like that? We'll save just to be sure. There we go. I didn't even need to increase it by that much. There. That's not that bad. Now we once again have a nice sniper rifle. See, I knew there was going to be something in the side of there. Not that any of you doubted me, of course, but... That was not me falling off and taking some really dumb damage just then. Oh, smooth operators for not triggering the alarm system, not for not killing people. Why the fuck do they let you jump that high if it's just gonna hurt you? Alright, enough fucking around. Let's head to administration and find the last rocket launcher part. Wherever that is. I don't even know how I'm supposed to get down from here without hurting myself. Okay, apparently wall... There's no way down from there. Yeah, I don't know. All right. Ha! Did it. Yes, that's... I feel like that's a... That's definitely a reason to save the game. I had to remember where this guy that sells... that where the guy who runs the armory is. And seeing these claustrophobic walls is going to start driving me nuts sooner rather than later. Alright, so this is like the admin sector or something, right? Administrative sector? Is that what this shit means? I'm gonna go nuts fairly quick. I'm actually going to go nuts going fucking circles like this, oh my god. That's a lightning strike just then. It's still thunderstorming outside, I guess. Still, he said it was in administration. The question is, where in administration is it? I hope they didn't, like, store it inside underneath one of these wiring things. I have to do some more crawling just to get to it. Or maybe it spawned in after I talked to the guy about it, and not before. This dude over here is hiding more hentai underneath his desk. Stun gun darts, credit chips, thank you. Yeah, we are definitely just here. Are you? Huh. That's interesting. Yeah. So this is what they call it in this timeline? Cybernetic discognition disorder? Interesting. Oh, that was not there before, was it? Was this inactive? I don't remember this being here. It is amazing you can go through this game several times and keep finding new things on new run-throughs. Is this it? Is that all this leads to? Oh wait, no. There we go. Okay. Ayo? Where am I? Oh, it's the big boss's room or whatever. Perks, retinal prosthesis. Bruh. From Tai Young Medical, no less.
Any reason Burke's got a spare retinal prosthesis lying around his office?
He just received it this evening from the Tai Young Medical Corporation. HQ had a custom set made especially for him as a thanks for so many years of good service. Why?
He'll probably be real angry when he realizes it's missing. Jensen out.
Hell yeah, he will be. Good fucking riddance, anyway. Asshole. Ooh, he's just got money just lying around too. I wonder if the missing piece or missing scope thing that I'm looking for is here in this room. Well, if it was, I don't fucking know where it is, honestly. The security system is shit. Just waltz right in, sneak right out. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Take all the beer. Drink his beer. I can't see shit anymore because I'm blind as a bat. Natanya Keitner, Space Operations. Her room is a lot less messy by comparison. It kind of looks like I just realized this architecture reminds me a lot of Doom 3. In any contracts of an ethically challenged nature? That's kind of funny. In retrospect. Because they're certainly not the good guys now. I say that this is great art, great in-game art. Happy birthday at the 12 Apostles. Found your earring yet? Looks like she's got a kid on the way, a kid over there who is sick, and another kid as well. This kind of reminds me of someone I know in real life, actually. She even looks like the same. Or maybe all military women just look the same, right? Stun gun darts. She's Jewish. I'm going to take a wild guess that's not in here. The thing I'm looking, missing part, scope part I'm looking for. Targeting scope assembly. It's probably stuffed in a locker like this one, I'm willing to bet. Is that a panic button? Decharge capacity. Some drawers. Tasteful art. Some map of the base. Useless books. Yeah, I have no idea. I legitimately don't know. We finish installation of your new save in the previously specified location, including the appropriate cover. Please let us know if there are any problems with the opening the trigger or the frame sliding mechanism, or if you're in some way unable to access the contents. Thought so! There's a fucking button! Okay. Bitch, where did it slide out of? Oh. I fucking love it, chap. You gotta love it. You gotta see. Yes. Oh yes. Oh yes. Oh, I'm gonna kill you with your own gun, you son of a bitch. And it's fully maxed out, too. I think. Oh, what a beautiful... Yeah, it doesn't let you increase any more of it. A custom-made variant of the standard Diamondback revolver. With a compact but dense frame, the Diamondback is a powerful pistol, but its short effective range and low ammunition. This one-of-a-kind special firearm was a gift to Pieter Burke from the CEO of Mustang AdTech for saving his life during a close protection mission early in Burke's career with Bell Tower. Comes with a full suite of built-in upgrades for damage, rate of fire, and reload speed, as well as an integral laser sight and gold surface finish. Uh, Oh, yeah. I'll sell the machine pistol and I'll dump the machine pistol itself. I could always come back for that later anyway. Okay. Well, chat, I was able to find Burke's special firearm. The only problem is this does not solve my other problem. Was this guy always here? If it's not in Burke's office, and it's not in Kieter's office, I wonder where it is. It is definitely here in the administration level. It's probably right under my nose too, which is the annoying part. The scope, I mean. So, if I look just real hard enough, it should reveal itself at some point. Or it might be in one of these rooms, honestly. God, the officers on base sure were horny. I guess I can't blame them. You ever wondered who this guy actually is? Armed and very dangerous. Clearly they worked for Square Enix at some point. I guess it's not in here. Because they're not in the gun safe. The game just saved. So we're in the loading bay again, okay. Altair Alpha. Natania Keitner for base operations. Get to work for Spec Ops. The game just saved again. Dead bodies everywhere. Logistics. Spec Ops. There it is. Found it. Cool. Now let's find Quinn, which I'm guessing is downstairs somewhere. I'm so glad we were able to find it, because I'm starting to get annoyed with how easy it was to get lost in this stupid base. Once we deliver this and sell all our other garbage, we can continue with the game chat. Where am I? What am I? What the fuck is this book? I guess we have to go downstairs, right? Let's take the elevator or something? Or maybe we don't even need to go that far. I could probably just... I forgot. We actually do have a map in this game. Look how freaking easy it is to get lost in this. Oh my god. Okay, there's a stairwell right there. Okay. Hello, beautiful.
Right. So, what's the story? Got those parts for me?
Yeah, take a look.
Hey, let me see what you got there. Fucking deadly. That's all of them. Give me a sec with me tools. I'll get them sorted out right and proper. Right then. That'll do you. Anything else I can be helping you with then?
Yeah, man.
Buy something or bugger off.
Don't tell me to bugger off. I did not just spend all that time just now getting you all this garbage for you to tell me to bugger off, mate. How about you bugger off? Shit, man. Burke's revolver is 2,000 gold. 2,000. Thanks for shopping at Quinn Mart. Woo-wee! Rocket launcher. Rocket launcher. I don't have enough room for this goddamn thing. But I have lots of practice kits now because of all the efforts I went to just to find these things. And it would be a waste of our hard-earned time and money if we didn't make use of that. Now would it? Wouldn't it? I'm loving it, chat. Oh, I also just remembered I do have a flashlight. Wait, no, that's actually a targeting system, not a flashlight. I do wonder if I can get in there though. So I see a praxis kit on the table. And I want it. I needs it, chat. Give me the praxis kits. But first, do you have any rocket launcher ammo?
Right. So, what's the story? Buy something or bugger off.
Oh, so here's what I'm going to do now, chat. I'm going to spend some time trying to get to that there praxis kit.
Right. So,
and other junk that's inside his area.
Buy something or bugger off.
I wonder if he's going to get upset if I let myself in. He probably will be. But you know what? It doesn't matter. He doesn't have any choice in the matter. Who's gonna stop me? Am I right?
Thanks for shopping at Quinn Mart.
I have plenty of monies. In any case. So we got full inventory again. We honestly got plenty of ammunition. Plenty of money left. But now, we need to find our way and to get inside there so I can take his Praxis kit and any other junk he may be having in those cases, but... How do we get in? Sight.
What can I do for you?
I gotta go.
Right. Do us both a favor. Keep your head down.
I don't see any obvious areas here where that would be possible, but I'm going... But I think there might be something back there. I just have a hunch, you know? Just a little hunch. Yellow. Yellow. No, this can't be right. It's going up. Yeah. Good night, Nicarin. Thank you for coming by. And thank you. Have a good night. Have a good sleep. Thank you for visiting. I'm sure we'll have an okay rest of the stream. Maybe. Just maybe. I'm just about to check the wiki to make sure I'm not going on a wild goose chase trying to find a way into that air, into Quinn's hidey hole. Oh, I found something, perhaps. I wonder where this leads us. Ed, I'm guessing I've never been past this area before because, yeah, I have never been in this area before. It's very easy to miss though. Damn, underneath the stairwell? Where are we, chat? Have I ever been here before? This is new. I think I've been in this room before. Poggers. Yeah, I've definitely never been in this room before. I don't remember this map being there. Is that a pocket secretary? Don't really need that, but pocket secretaries are pocket secretaries, I suppose. How did I miss this room anyway? Weird. Kind of annoyed because that means that the place that I'm looking for must be why is there stairs there? Unless it goes upstairs. Brooks' office. Ah, goes upstairs. There's something I'm missing. The secrets are hiding in plain sight. In little areas I don't think I can access, at first don't seem accessible, but actually totally are. This is going to be mildly annoying, but at least we know what to look for now. These little crawl spaces underneath the stairs. Probably been here before. Yeah, Typhoon ammo. I've been in this area before. This comes from the bathroom. It goes to the bathroom. I'm wondering if I need to progress to the next area and then I can go down there somehow. Because this is where the thing is. I'm certain of it. And the security checkpoint's over here. If I just save before we enter there, that will fix any of the problems with the game, like hard locking me out, I suppose. Oh, so that's where the combat rifle is hiding. Too bad solo my common rifle stuff already. Okay.
Activating security scan.
Activating security scan. What a shitty computer scanner.
Subject recognized. Access granted.
Oh yeah, baby, grant me that access. Sus. Oh, shit. Yeah, this is a different area altogether. Damn it.
Activating security scan.
Okay, I'm gonna look it up now. Okay. I see. So it looks like getting into his shop is going to be a lot more difficult than I thought. It's not something you can just sneak your way into. It's part of a quest. Let's go ahead and continue then, I suppose. Looks like we also have some new moral options to go through in the rest of this game, which should be interesting.
Subject recognized. Access granted.
I also just realized that this is actually a hidden loading screen. This whole section. I probably shouldn't be too surprised, but. I also tried to kill a few people this time. Whether I'll be successful or not is anyone's guess, though.
Subject recognized. Access granted.
Here we go. Where's that voice ever coming from?
Aspiring to commit a terrorist act. After processing, you will undergo a preliminary medical examination. At that point, I'm sure you will have the opportunity to raise your concerns.
Why am I being held here? A terrorist? Where are we? No. They just trapped me up the street. You've got the wrong person. You can't lock up someone who's
We will determine if you are the right or wrong person. If you cooperate, things will go smoothly. If not, you will be made to cooperate.
Oh, good. Please. This is wrong. You can't just hold me here.
Doesn't look like I can break through these doors all that easily.
You can't hold us here indefinitely without trial. We have rights under the Geneva Convention.
More like the Geneva Suggestion, am I right? For a cell block, this is a fairly empty place.
No, not again. What more do they want from me, please? I've answered all their questions. Tell them I'm not sick.
There's some guards over there. We'll have to take them out quietly. I do believe I just choked the shit out of those two. Pog. Well, that's easy.
Please. Tell me what's going on back there, in the examination area. They took Leanne back there 2 days ago, but she hasn't come back.
I do wonder what's...
I guess it's your turn, Tom, right?
Please, don't send me to the doctors!
Now you want a piece.
That's kind of dark. This one's unlocked. About Charles Darwin and Origin of Species. Some shoes, some magazines, some books, a toilet. Whatever the fuck that is. It's very grim, chat. Very grim indeed. I'm afraid it looks like they're already a couple steps ahead of that, my dear. Oh, what the fuck? I heard it, but I didn't see it. But what was that? I legit don't know where that noise came from. Something on the scanner, though. I don't see a camera anywhere. Where was it? Whatever that thing was that made that noise. Did not notice the corpse of the bodies I left. So we should be good for now, but the radar is picking something up. Curious.
Access granted.
Pog. Okay. There's no one else here. Excellent. We don't have any stop worms anymore. This is gonna be a problem.
Access granted.
Very good. But it is not letting me unlock anything. Wonder if I need to have control to the bots to be able to access those. I don't have any praxis kits, so I can't do that. This is kind of a problem. Yeah. Diet slob? Is that really his handle? That's funny. Honestly.
Access granted.
Interesting. Cracks in the walls, huh? You don't say. Okay.
Kuitner, Jensen, I'm in your detention camp and uploading to the security mainframe now.
Copy that. Any problems?
Nothing I couldn't get rid of.
Yeah, well, we'll talk about that later. Right now, you need to get inside the interrogation wing and find out what Burke is hiding. Contact me when you know. Kuitner out.
Pog. Got some practice points as well. Yeah, then let's see if this will be more useful to us. Bingo. Set to enemies only or disable? Oh, set to enemies only. The people in this part of the station are kind of immoral anyway. I don't think anyone's gonna miss them. Good bot. Good bot is good bot.
Why am I being held here? Where are we?
我不能容忍的，这是对正义的道路。我不是恐怖分子，我是自由战士。
I do believe terrorists and freedom fighters are more or less the same thing. At least as far as the governments are concerned. Just a copypasta of the one downstairs. Are they playing solitaire? Looks like it.
I haven't done anything. Why have you locked me up? You can't do that! We have
Interrogation wing, huh? Oh, that's a fancy looking machine. Wonder if there's a way to disable that. Or maybe... Oh... It's not designed how I thought, chat. Hello, Sar. How are you doing tonight? Welcome to the stream. What the fuck was that? It exploded! What the shit? Your garage door is fucked? Why is it fucked?
I'm an innocent man.
What happened to your garage door?
You can't just sweep us under a rock like this.
The internals, the engine snapped? Oh dear, that sounds dangerous. I hope it didn't like fall on anyone or anything. Doesn't look like there's any way to disable these things, so we are gonna have a problem if I don't find a way around those. Seem easy enough to avoid, actually.
You're not one of them. Please, the scientists, they've been testing it. And worse, the commander.
Alright. Ignored Lamau. Indeed. Ban in game action, having fun. Well, I guess that's the end of the stream chat. We're gonna go ahead and things now, and we're going to reconvene again on Friday, since it is no longer possible to have fun in this stream. Alright then. Good night, everyone. Have a good one. I'm kidding. I'm not going to actually quit the stream. Can you imagine if I did, though? Nah, that'd be a dick move, even by VTuber standards. Don't worry, I'm not going to quit just yet. However, I don't know in what way I would play this without having fun. I guess I could try playing it loud again, but... I'm afraid you'll have to specify. It's just a meme. I see what you're doing. I see what you're doing. Is that really all we could do in this level, though, or is there more to this? Oh, wait, no. There actually are more stairs, I think. Or there's the stairs we came up. There's probably the stairs we came up. It looks like we will need to go to the interrogation wing after all. It seems a little too easy, though. A little too quiet.
Activating security scanner. Biometric data assembled. Subject. Recognized. Access granted.
I have a bad feeling about this chat. I wonder what's gonna happen next. Oh, wow. This does not look ominous at all. Totally. No fun allowed. Thank you for the clip, Steel. Ooh, Mr. Page.
Unwilling human test subjects, is he? What's his opinion on Bell Tower using the OCM to further their military aspirations? Ask him about this Hydra project.
Tiffany, calm down. I know all about the Hydra project. It's nothing nefarious.
These are all references to the first Deus Ex.
Communicate more efficiently when in the field. You've seen Burke's augmentation. It has nothing to do...
Am I going to be playing Mankind Divided? Sure. It takes place directly after this game. Yeah. These are all references to the first Deus Ex game. It's nice that they put that in. Honestly. Is what true? I heard Invisible War is bad and not fun. My understanding was Invisible War was a okay FPS game for the time, but it was a terrible Deus Ex game. I've only managed to play a little bit myself, and it's true that the models were actually worse than in the first one. They were very stiff. They weren't as expressive. There's also some weird design choices, like the fact that every gun uses the same ammunition in that game. But a lot of the mechanics like sneaking around, using various ways to complete the same objective, stuff like that remained. And there was some fun dialogue in there and some fun characters in there, I thought. But other than that, it was quite jank. There's also some... I'm assuming people also did not like the ending, which I will not spoil. But I don't know, it was a weird game. It was not a game that people could say that they actually hated, but when compared to the original Deus Ex, everyone pretty much agreed it was inferior to the first Deus Ex. And I will have to agree that I think as far as comparisons were, the first Deus Ex was still the better game overall. Why that is, though, you'll just have to wait and find out. Because I will not spoil it.
I'm sorry, I'll stay quiet, I promise. Just
don't hurt me anymore.
Calm down. I'm not gonna hurt you.
You're not one of them? One of the scientists? Please, you've got to get me out of here. You've got to do something before they come back. I don't want to disappear like all the others.
It's okay. What's your name?
Nina. Nina Sullivan. I don't know why they're holding me in here. They just grabbed me off.
Cape Town, huh?
I heard Cape Town is dangerous, but I thought with all the security around.
Cape Town? South Africa?
Isn't that where we are?
No.
They drugged me, I think. I was on vacation in Cape Town at the end of the summer. I was going to be starting senior year in the fall, and I wanted to have an adventure. My parents must be so worried.
I take it you're not a terrorist, then?
No. I've never done anything wrong. Never demonstrated against anything or anything. But neither have most of the girls here. I'm not sure about the men, but please, can't you get me out of here?
Hold on. You said they were coming back? Who? Burke? Is he behind this?
I'm not sure. He comes around, but not that often. I know he gives the orders around here, but he doesn't seem all that interested in us beyond some psych tests and questioning. He mostly leaves us to the doctors or scientists or whatever they are.
Tell me about these scientists. Is one of them a woman named Reed?
I don't know. I mean, there is a woman, but her name is Kavanaugh, not Reed. I heard the guard call her that. She seems different. Like, she doesn't like what they're doing to us. I can't help but think she's being forced to do these things. The others just treat us like animals. It's horrible. I just want to go home.
I want to help you, but you've got to stay calm. And what did you mean by disappear like the others? What's been going on back here?
I don't know much. I've heard rumors and seen some things, and I know what they've done to me. Biopsies, blood samples, tissue cores, like I'm some sort of lab rat.
Is that why you're back here? Separated from the others?
This is where they...
You know what? I just realized that they updated the models for all the characters and stuff, but they also updated the way Adam Jensen's eyes work. In the vanilla game, it doesn't really make sense why those little shades just pop out of his eyes. But in this one, you could kind of expand a little bit, and they're a little bit bigger.
Why? What makes you think that?
Because of the way they talk when they're with us. It's like they're looking for some kind of perfect gene match or something. Not a doctor. I don't understand it. I just don't want them touching me anymore.
I know this is gonna seem cruel, but I can't help you right now.
You're going to leave me here? You can't. You have no idea what it's like. Please.
I can't have you tagging along just yet, or walking the halls alerting the guards. Trust me. When I can get you out, I will. But your best bet is to stay put.
I'll alert them anyway. Burke and the two doctors were just here heading for the morgue. I'll tell them you're here. I will. Let me out or I'll tell them, I swear.
And then what? Do you really think they'll let you go? I'm still the best chance you've got, but you have to be patient.
Please. Don't go.
Oh, shit. Well, that was unique, actually. Oh, what nightmare did I just walk into?
Thank you.
A lot of supplies and augmentations here in this room. Wonder if there's a praxis kit or two we can steal. Wouldn't that be convenient right now? I know it sure as hell would be. No dice though. Praxis is just super chocolate? Damn right you are. Associations low, prostitute. 1993? 34 years old? Possible gliomas, rupture of cerebral arteries? Oh, fuck. This person had a stroke. No counterindications. No visible augmentation work. Hyperdose MPZ pass. Neuropazine. Status terminated. Shit, man! This is a morgue! The fuck is that? Oh, that's a very dead person, looks like. Ooh, boy. Criminal organization, suspected harvester runner. Delusional machine god. She believes, yes, she did. Another data storage device. I'm wondering if I was supposed to put this somewhere else. I didn't see a place to install it. Indeed, she serves even in death. Praise the Omnissiah. Versalife. Okay. That's been recorded. Nothing else of interest in this room. Oh, wait, credit chip. I don't see anything here special, do you? No hidden buttons this time? Good. I'll put a bullet in Burke's head when I get the chance. Something seems kind of sus. I better save. Let's see what goes behind the door. No one here?
So what did these ones die of, Savage?
A complete neurological breakdown from the looks of it. Organ collapse, nerve degradation.
Find him. There's been some trouble on the base. My man will take care of it. You were saying?
We may be looking at serious cross-systemic failure issues with the OCM.
It's those god-awful implants, Gary. The whole inhumane procedure. After a while, it just burns them out.
Has this been happening at the other sites?
We've experienced some die-off, yes. But I've been told Dr. Reed's research may offer a breakthrough. If we could bring her back here...
That's not going to happen.
Then we need to start considering other options. A nanotech-based solution performed on willing volunteers.
And are you volunteering yourself, Doctor?
Tiffany, please. I need to look at the raw data, Commander. If you would.
I turned a blind eye to your little office romance, Savage. But if she becomes a problem, she will be volunteering.
So that's the reason why we picked up that cochlear implant.
Kuitner, I found out what Burke's been concealing. The interrogation wing is some kind of medical testing facility. He's using the prisoners as
labs. Cochlear implant, thank you.
For what?
Not sure. I'll need Burke's retinal scan data to find out.
I can't download that without setting off a million alarms. However, you still have that retinal prosthesis you stole from his office?
If you're suggesting I use it to fool a retinal scanner, it won't work. The eye synthetic tissue spike needs to be connected to a real optic nerve. Otherwise, it just reads as metal.
I know. That's why you need to take it to Quinn. I'll tell him to expect you. Kuitner out.
Very pog. So we're going back the way we came. Let's go loot the shit out of this room first. Because I have a feeling we're not coming back this way, at least not for a while, maybe not until the end game. Sure are a lot of dead bodies here though. Damn. Yeah. No accessing that, I guess. I don't see anything shiny in this room, which implies that there may not be anything to loot, and I could be... You never know, though. There's some combat rifle ammo right there. Don't need that though. I don't have any combat rifle, so I don't have a combat rifle with me this time. Nothing up here, it seems. Wait. I feel like a cat. Going through these top shelves, just moving everything around. Oh, I thought that was the case. There is a cardboard box here, but it's not what I'm looking for. Typhoon ammunition, but I don't use a typhoon. So that will not be useful to me. I could probably sell it though for some money. I can't bring it with me. I'm not gonna bother. Okay. Should probably just make our way back, huh? Yeah. I can't help but feel like the game is setting me up for a fall though. This seems too easy.
changed your mind. You'll let me out now? Please, they'll be back and I'll disappear like all the other women.
Is this still not gonna let me?
Sorry.
For fuck's sake. There's gotta be an option to save her at some point. Maybe not right now. I guess she would have a hard time getting back the way we came anyway because of all the guards and shit that I knocked out and also the droids. There shouldn't be any other resistance out here though. But she would have also never gone through this thing anyway, would she?
Activating security scan. Biometric data assembled.
We haven't heard anything from our mysterious hacker friend in a while either.
Access granted.
I have an idea of who it might be. Coochie implant. Yeah. I could use a coochie implant. If I had put some points into the jumping add-on, I could have just leapt from here, but I did not. Coochie implant or second penner? Why not both? You can't just have just one. No, you have to choose? Well, that's heresy. There's a ladder here? Wait, what? What ladder? Oh shit! Good thing I didn't leave yet. A whole section here that I missed. I can't see either. Oh, here we go. Nothing special over here, it looks like. And I threw some boxes down here earlier. Well, that was something of a killjoy. Jesus fucking Christ! Calm your tits, hacking minigame. God.
Please, tell me what's going on back there in the examination area. They took Leanne back there 2 days ago, but she hasn't come back.
How do I get out of this level? I actually don't remember how I got to this section either.
Listen to me. I've done nothing wrong.
That's what they all say. You must reset your facial emotion subroutine. How do you know this was not just as planned? thank you for the reminder. It has a tendency to just get stuck like that sometimes, you know?
Subject recognized. Access granted.
Am I hearing things? Oh, shit. Guess new soldiers have been spawned into the game, huh? Cringe. Oh, my goodness. That's a lot of them. There's one over here, too. Using grenades is probably not a good idea. But, as it turns out, this thing is fairly long range. I don't have any explanation for this. I'm sorry. You saw nothing. You saw nothing, my good sir. You saw nothing. There's nothing to see here. Move along. Move along.
Prosthetic eye, one of Burke's. We need it to get past a retinal scan, but it's useless like this.
Aye. Without an active neural connection, it might as well be an expensive paperweight. May as well put a gobstopper in front of the scanner for all the good that thing will do you.
Solutions, Quinn. Think you can handle this?
Lad, I may be just a mechanic, but I'm also the only thing keeping this whole bleeding facility from sinking into the abyss. Think I can manage a simple optic frequency bypass. Just let me get me tools. Right.
Pog champ.
You got the eye. Sorry it took a little longer than I expected. Nearly break the damn thing once or twice. New TYM firmware and such. I don't don't go fucking around with it. It's only got a limited lifespan due to the temp power.
Hey, Chaos. It's only good for one. Long time no see. It has been quite a while. How have you been?
This is pretty impressive work for a mechanic, Quinn.
Welcome back.
What's that supposed to mean? There's more to old Quinn than meets the eye. No pun intended.
Have you been? Why do you have a... Well, there's more. Why do you have a new username?
I saw you modifying the BIOS.
Ah!
It's state-of-the-art hardware and software. You're not just a mechanic. You're a hacker.
Ain't nothing you couldn't pull off with a degree in computer engineering and a little elbow grease. Come off it now. We ain't got time.
We got time for this, because yes.
Is it supposed to be moving?
Aye.
Bloody creepy that is. Try not to pay it any money.
Things stuck in calibration mode. Trick is...
Indeed, Chaos Wish does fit you more.
And by rewriting the system diagnostic checks, it'll keep trying to connect without detecting anything to miss, which in turn keeps it alive in a manner of speaking. Fucking brilliant piece of engineering work, if I don't say so myself.
One use?
Why only one use?
Without being hooked up to a proper battery, like your brain, the voltage spike from a single scan will trip the surge protectors, shutting it down to prevent further transmissions. It's a redundant safety mechanism built into the optic nerve to prevent frying your noggin in a dorsal ventral feedback loop. Short of putting the thing in your own head, which I ain't exactly equipped to do, there's no way around it. Besides, I think the commander preferred this way.
Thank you for the lurk.
Well, hopefully this thing works.
It'll work just dandy so long as you don't do something stupid like drop it. And it ain't a bloody webcam. So don't try using it to spy the knickers up someone's skirt.
Ayo. Enter shop.
Money back guarantee or warranty. You break it, you buy it.
Yeah, I should have picked up more combat rifle ammo so I could just sell it back to him. There's not even a point in buying a laser targeting system at this point, is there? I wonder if the rocket launcher can actually take one. No, can't accept a laser targeting system anyway. Alright. Don't forget to drop a follow, Chaos Wish, unless you're using a different... Unless this is the same account with a different name. Really glad you came back, though. I kind of miss my regulars, and I feel bad that y'all have had to go without me for so long. The circumstances were certainly not ideal, that's for sure.
Subject recognized. Access granted.
I just realized something. I wonder if accessing the secret elevator is going to hard lock me out of this area. Since it's apparently only one use. So I can only imagine it's a one-way trip, right? I guess we'll have to find out. If the guides I was reading are correct, we should be heading back this way eventually anyway. So maybe it'll be okay.
What you're doing is wrong.
Having to go through two of these fucking security checkpoints though. It's getting kind of troublesome, isn't it?
Biometric data assembled. Subject recognized. Access granted.
Something still seems too easy about this, though. Like I'm being set up for a fall or something.
Access granted.
In before there's a cutscene where I go face to face with Burke. Oh, underwater, huh? We in the city of Rapture yet?
Jensen, it's Keitner. Where are you?
In a well-concealed elevator inside the prison's restricted wing. Your gun-running neural engineer deserves a raise.
I take it the eye worked then. Good. Now listen, if what you say is true, if Burke really is using the prisoners here as lab rats, I need proof. Hard evidence that I can take to Interpol.
An entire prison full of kidnapped civilians isn't enough?
You're an ex-cop, Jensen. You tell me. How many death row inmates crying on about their innocence have you seen getting out?
Point taken. I'll see what I can find.
Ooh, they have those wave machine generators. There's a wave machine power generators. I don't know how we're going to be getting out of this one, chap. 2 hours, 59 minutes? Dang. Time sure flew this time, huh? Didn't even realize it's been 3 hours. Gotta say, though, this scenery is far, far more interesting than all that shit above. Oh, Jesus.
Please don't leave me like this. No hope.
That's not disturbing at all. Fuck, man, this is reminding me way too much of that one game where the first things you do is also get a cyber thing installed in your skeleton and shit. That's where we plugged in the thing.
So sorry. Don't hurt me anymore.
Worldwide access terminal. That's where we plugged in the quest item that we found. The data storage device. I don't understand what any of this means, of course, but... And it's also giving us experience points, too. Very pog. Got looks like a carrier ship over there. Is optional objectives, I suppose. Synthetic thought, the human AI. Can machine think like man? Well, I am fairly biased, but I'm likely to believe that the answer is yes, chat.
Can't take anymore. Want to die.
Bruh. Clones and shit, man. Whenever I get a body of my own, I will request that they do not look like this.
I'm sorry. So sorry. Don't hurt me anymore.
Trank darts. Commercial space station. The fuck is that? Why does it have such large eyelashes? Like, God. Here's the bitch.
According to Commander Burke, initial field tests are positive. Operatives report function within expected parameters. Never mind the cost.
Yeah, Deus Ex right here. Oh, so there's a fourth one that I'm missing somewhere. Oh, there it is. I was gonna say, pretty sure I didn't miss anything. Moonbase Omega? A moonbase? What the fuck? The learned scholar got an achievement. Test subjects revealed no statistically significant changes in glial tissue buildup and subsequent
degeneration. Quite the house of horrors you got here, Doc. You letting anyone in or just women?
Who are you? How'd you get down here? This is a restricted area.
Obviously. You wouldn't want the rank and file knowing what kind of sick experimentation is going on down here.
No. You don't understand. I'm not...
Where's Burke? And your research partner, Savage?
Burke went back up to the base. And Gary left. Told me to be smart, keep my mouth shut, and do whatever Burke tells me to do. For now.
For now? I heard the three of you talking up there in the morgue. Sounded like you don't exactly fit in here, Dr.
Kavanaugh. And who the fuck are you?
The name's Jensen. I came here looking for someone. Megan Reed.
Reed? I've seen her research. Gary thinks it could be the key we're missing. If she can be convinced to come here.
Megan Reed was kidnapped, Kavanaugh. Violently. As was her entire scientific team and the dozens of women you've been torturing down here.
No! You don't understand. I'm trying to save them. Gary and I, we were sent here to put the OCM project back on track. It wasn't until we got here that we realized what that meant. And by then it was too late.
OCM. Savage used that term in the morgue. What does it mean?
Organic computational matrix. It's a means of cross-connecting living brain tissue and artificial intelligence systems to create a supercomputer of unparalleled capability.
Trying.
Part flesh, part silicon.
That's what you're doing down here, turning prisoners into computer parts.
Ayo.
Brain activity has to be integrated with the technology, or else it won't work. Even DARPA knew that.
That's not completely true. The humans of this timeline have managed to find ways around that, but then again, this game was made in the early 2010s. It kind of excites me though. Since this game takes place in 2027, this means that in my host's lifetime we may find a form of CBI.
Just how many prisoners are being wired into this thing?
I don't know. But a lot of them don't seem to survive for more than a year. I've told the others there's no way this project can stay viable with these kinds of numbers. But the OCM computers have to have them to work.
Computers? You mean there's more than one of them?
There's several. This is just where the process starts. The factory floor. We select the candidates here, implant them, and ship them to the other locations. It's all very efficient.
Yeah, except your candidates keep dying.
DARPA.
What does DARPA have to do with this?
Nothing. Not directly. In 2007, they started looking for research partners to help develop an artificial cognitive science program that could increase a soldier's situational awareness in the field. A number of private sector companies submitted proposals.
Bell Tower being one of them.
No. Bell Tower was a private military corporation. DARPA wanted researchers. But one of the companies who did submit something was a biotech corporation that deals with Bell Tower. And they believed a successful program could be designed if it could be wired directly into the soldiers' brains. DARPA wasn't willing to go that far.
So this biotech company took the idea to Bell Tower.
A corporation that, being privately funded, doesn't have to concern itself with political or ethical debate.
Wow, you're a bitch.
You seem to think Megan's research is integral to salvaging this project of yours. Why?
It's not my project. Had I known before I came here...
Right, just answer the question.
We're experiencing cross-systemic failures with the tech. Over time, subjects implanted with OCM augmentations suffer complete neurological breakdown. They pretty much burn up from the inside. Gary thinks it's a problem with the acceptance of the P-dot array.
I've heard that phrase before.
It's the building block of modern neuroaugmentations. Dr. Reed's been reshaping it, changing the way it bonds with living tissue. The mutagenic gene combination she's introduced into it, well, frankly, it's astonishing.
Enough to warrant her kidnapping? So she'd be forced to work on this project with you?
She's not on this project. I don't know what she's doing or where she is. This is the first time anyone's ever mentioned kidnapping.
You're really gonna stand there and try to justify your role in this, aren't you? People are being enslaved, Kavanaugh. Enslaved and crucified.
It wasn't like that at first. I thought we were gonna make a difference, do something incredible for the world.
Right. And look how incredible it turned out to be. But you can still make a difference, Doctor. You can help me blow the lid off this place.
Are you insane? I can't. There's too much money invested in this. Burke, the people I work for, they'll kill me. They'll hunt me down and kill me.
I know people who can protect you, hide you. Interpol is just waiting for evidence to tear Bell Tower apart.
It's not just Bell Tower. Oh, God. Oh, God, am I really gonna do this? You can't get me out through the prison. Burke would stop us.
Then we'll have to do what Savage did. Take a submersible.
We can't. The hatches to all the docking hangars are locked tight. The only way to unlock them is by using the security console in the prison command tower. Burke keeps an eye on us that way.
Then I'll have to go back up there and unlock it. Well, you gather as much evidence as you can carry.
Oh, my God. I'm really gonna do this.
Damn right you are. Now get moving. I'll contact you when I unlock the hatch.
All right, fine. But Mr. Jensen, please, hurry.
Get Kavanaugh off the base. I wonder if I can get the other prisoner who's locked upstairs off the base along with her. It's getting pretty late though. It's 3:10. It's 12:10. Looks like we're able to complete all these sections. A load of shit is what you got yourselves into, Dr. Kavanaugh.
I'm working as fast as I can, Mr. Jensen. There's just so much data. The OCM project is quite complex, and I don't want to trigger any security alerts that might warn Burke of what we're doing.
Got it. That's all I wanted to know. I'll be in touch soon.
Can't believe I agreed to this.
I'm sorry. So sorry. Don't hurt me anymore. So cold. Can't take any more. Want to die.
So much reading, fuck.
I'm sorry. So sorry. anymore.
Bob sure talks a lot, just like in the first game. I can't help but feel like Savage just abandoned Tiffany. Fred decided this shit's way too hot.
So cold. So cold.
So Burke is apparently insane. He used to be in the U.S. Marine Corps.
Sorry. So
fairly sexist.
Don't hurt me.
Lots of augmentations.
Please, please don't leave me like this. No.
Is there anything else that could be checked? Or are we good here? More pro energy packs. And 2 available praxis kits, chat. Once we take the elevator back up, we'll go ahead and end the evening.
Keitner, contact Interpol. We need rendezvous coordinates for a deep-sea submersible.
A what? What exactly have you found, Jensen?
A research complex hidden beneath this base. One of its staff is willing to turn whistleblower if we can deliver her to Interpol using one of the lab's transport subs.
Which explains why you need the coordinates. I'll see what I can do. Keitner out.
It's not gonna be that easy. No way, Jose. Oh, shit.
Keitner, what the hell's going on? The elevator stopped.
Burke must have intercepted our comms. Get the hell out of there, Jensen. I'll meet you.
Yeah, I got a bad feeling about this. But we are going to end it there for now. Now things are getting spicy. Let's go find someone to raid tonight. It looks like Deus Ex has crashed once again. Epic gaming, epic coding, developing, gaming. Who is awake this evening anyway? And why is Firefox not bringing up? Fever Skull is doing stuff? I'll consider them. Let me look online really quick. Internet's not doing so well tonight, though. Sure, it's taking a while just to load up Twitch, for example. Mai is streaming Amori. There's a lot of people streaming tonight, actually. Maxwell's playing Dead Space. Christian's doing Hunt Showdown. Carrie Dreen has started streaming again, too. She's playing Last Epoch. Dead Cells is so good. Indeed. 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 Let's see about your friend, though. Vapor Skull. Let's see what they're up to. Vapor Skull. This person? Robocop hitting the gritty. They're playing. Oh my god, they're playing as Robocop in Fortnite. That's interesting. They kind of remind me of the main character from that Let It Die video game. He's a pretty cool dude. I'm always up for raiding a new person, so Vapor Skull could be interesting. Do they let people talk in here without having to follow them first? They do. We've been having an issue with raiding people that don't allow non-followers to talk, so we'll do Vapor Skull tonight. For tonight's raid message, we're going to do... We totally asked for this. Woke. Not many viewers tonight, but that's alright. I understand Deus Ex is kind of a slow game sometimes, but thank you everyone for coming tonight and for SarVT for the suggestion. We will go ahead and get going. I'll see y'all on Friday. See y'all later. No problem, Sar. Thank you for coming tonight.